Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our science class. Students, in the previous class, we had learnt about the definition of chemical equations. Today, we will learn about balancing a chemical equation. So, let's start. Children, do you know what is the need of balancing a chemical equation? Well, in chemistry, we obey the law of conservation of mass, according to which number of atoms of each element, that is, on the left-hand side, which are reactants, should be equal to the number of atoms of elements on the right-hand side, that is, products. So, this is the reason why we need to balance a chemical equation. So, children, we will now learn the steps involved in the balancing of an unbalanced chemical equation. Let us consider the reaction between hydrogen and oxygen to form water. The word equation for the reaction is hydrogen plus oxygen gives water. So, the first step is that we have to write the word equation to chemical equation using symbols and chemical formulas. H2 plus O2 gives H2O, that is water. Children, please note that while writing the chemical equation, for elements, we have to write the atomicity with the symbols of element, and for compounds, always write the valency of the compound. So, now equation is H2 plus O2 gives H2O. Next, now count the number of atoms of each element present on both the sides, that is left hand side and right hand side of the equation. Well, in the above table, the number of hydrogen atoms are balanced, but the number of oxygen atoms are unbalanced. So, in order to balance the number of oxygen atoms, let us multiply H2O with 2. So, the equation becomes H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O. Remember, children, 2 is the coefficient here. Next, however, by doing so, the number of hydrogen atoms becomes unbalanced. These can be balanced if we multiply H2 on the left hand side with 2. Thus, we will get 2H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O. Next, now the number of atoms of each element present on both the sides of the equation are the same as shown in the table. So, we can check here H having 4 number of atoms, similarly on the left hand side and on the right hand side. Oxygen having 2 atoms on the left hand side as well as on the right hand side. Hence, the equation is now balanced. So, I hope, children, now you have an understanding of balancing a chemical equation. Thank you.